Hello and welcome to another one of our videos where we share with you what we have purchased at our local boot sale. And let me start things off they're homemade covers covering 1930s wildflower cigarette card items. And I bought these. They're very, very tatty, and I paid £1 for three of these. Okay, nothing to write home about, and in retrospect, although all the cards are complete, these are series one and series two. They're not good enough, in my opinion, to carefully remove and mount in a frame, etc. So it's too much legwork. So, I will put these back on my stall for £1 each, and they'll go. Flowers don't go so much as trains and cars and more exciting things like that, but flowers not so much. Apparently the woman who did these, who was the great grandmother of the person I bought them from, apparently she smoked like a chimney. hence two sets of cards.
Yeah.
Okay, next item. Miranda 8x40 binoculars.
You do like your binoculars.
Yeah, I do. Now, the reason why I bought these was, apart from the fact that, in my humble opinion, at least with budget binoculars, Miranda are fantastic, relatively fantastic. The gentleman wanted £12 for these, and I knocked him down to £5, which I thought was really, really good, and they came in a case, and they are absolutely superb. One of the best set of binoculars I bought recently.
They do look really good, don't they?
Yeah. So yeah. If I was selling those on eBay, I'd get £10 to £15.
Wow.
Okay. It comes complete with a case and lens cap. So fantastic. There we go.
Excellent.
So, next item is just a nice plate from Animal World. Okay. I paid 20p for this, and just a nice plate. Not great, but it's got a couple of scratches, but probably an easy 50p at a Carboot, even though I paid 20.
Yeah.
So there we go. Next item. Awesome. Okay, and on a similar vein, just a jug, milk jug, water jug, what have you. Nothing on the bottom. Again, 20p. Can't go wrong. Next item.
Wow.
Okay, got three pictures here.
It's only dawned on me, with all these items that you're buying each week,
yeah.
You must have a really big boot to put this all in.
Well, it's like a hatchback, so I fold the seats down, and then that becomes a big area to put the stuff. Yeah. Right, nice print of a confectioner's shop. And what's this? Ivy Harris by Barry Smith from an original painting. Okay, so it's nice on the back. Now this sort of thing easily sells for £1 or £2. Nice frame. I paid 50p. Can't go wrong.
That's beautiful.
Okay, next one. Like nice. Now, although this is quite inexpensive, it's never been hung. It's got the choice of hanging it there or putting the eyelets in, but what a nice little it says £1, but I paid 50p for it.
It's Thomas and his friend.
Thomas the Tank Engine. I can quite easily double my
can you can you name them?
No, I can't. Other than that, that's Thomas, that's Gordon, I think that's the fat controller.
Yeah.
I don't know the others.
Okay.
My grandchildren probably do.
Yep.
But I don't. But there we go. A nice piece for a bedroom wall.
That is beautiful. Yeah.
Probably something like $9.99 when it was new, but to me 50p, and to someone else £1, brilliant.
Yeah.
Okay. And finally, we have a DG Chatfield ink drawing. This is a canal scene. I believe it's Stoke Bruin, and D.G. Chatfield, he actually lived not too far from where this was drawn, and he signed it. He's no longer with us. I think he died 6 or 7 years ago. There's some stuff on the BBC about DJ Chatfield and that. So I paid, how much did I pay for this? I paid £1.50.
Wow.
I think this has got legs, but I'm not sure how far I can go with this. So what I'm going to do, this is going to go into an art shop that sells this type of thing, and then they're going to sell it for me on commission.
Okay.
So there we go. Bit of a short video today.
Yeah, yeah.
Thanks very much for sharing this stuff with us, and I'll do another video shortly. Thank you.
See you next time.